Yes, sir! What's going on, everybody? Look at the guns, damn it. Look at the guns. What's going on, everybody? Oh, look at them guns, too. He twirling his. Everybody, it's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ, coming to you live. Listen, man, everybody can get it, like you see my man T. Mills will tell him, because we got three shooters. Now, they have a pure sharpshooter. We have a pure sharpshooter. 6'10 is finesse. The CJ So Cool Bill. You know, I've got a shooter, and look at Ashy Booty eat in the background, man. We don't know if he eats Ashy Booties or if he's Ashy and he eats booties, but hey, it is what it is. That's his name. Anyway, like I was saying, man, I've never witnessed a good sharpshooter, a good pure sharpshooter, because most of the time what we get is guys that pull up, cash, pipe it up, I got the price on reserve. Most of the time what we get is guys that play point guard at pure sharp and stuff like that, and a lot of times, the only thing it is left, right, and behind screens, right? But I've never really seen anybody play this game like I see J.O. play and like I see Swante. Well, Swante plays off the dribble a lot. But the way I've seen J.O. play, where he runs around, I never should have left him open, but you know, I knew he could hit that. Where J.O. just runs around and gets open and he plays off ball. They set off ball screens for him and they get him open by dribbling him open. Pull up, green beam, money team! Where they put, you know, they do all that stuff. I've never had one of those on my team. Like I say, I play with Saucy. Saucy can pull up from anywhere. That's my morning time point guard. Get that out of here! Saucy is my morning time point guard, right? But he's, obviously, he's on the ball also because he's a point guard. Look at that mid-range brick. Hey, if it ain't from 35 feet, man, he ain't hitting it. But this guy right here, this 6'10", they let this dude play defense. They let, like, obviously he's gonna hit shots, right? He plays off the ball. I set screens off the ball for him. Look at how he just moves. He just moves around and he sets screens. He does a little bit of everything. And he even passes the ball, but finesse, look, kick it out. Trays up, splash down. Look at that, finesse normally plays point guard in the morning also. So he's got a high IQ. I've never really seen anybody play this. I'm not saying that it's hard to do. I'm just saying that I haven't seen it. Just like, well, I'm not saying that Aurora Borealis is the most rare thing in the world. I'm just saying that I have never seen it up close and personal. That's all I'm saying. So when you got one of these guys on your team, like J.O. said, pull up, brick. Anyway, when you got one of these guys on your team and they're hitting, like J.O. the Don says, man, they put points on the board in a hurry. Dude, the games were getting over so quickly. And stuff like this, they're letting this man play defense, finish in transition, finish in traffic sometimes, and he's hitting threes. Dude, it ain't fair. Like I said, most of the time, this is all we get is people playing. Look at that steal, man. That's a thing of beauty. I'm testing out something on steals, man. So we're gonna check that out. But I'll let you guys know if that really works. Woo, look at that thing, drive by rack. This is what this thing does, man. When you have a pure sharpshooter on the floor, the whole floor is open. And we have three shooters, so nobody can just be like, hey, we're not gonna play. You know, we're not gonna play these guys. What are you doing, man? I found something on that too. Like I said, playing against Swift, I learned my lesson. I figured out how to play against that stuff. So with this guy, with me having a defending guy, so you're not really gonna really get to the rim like that. And if you do, you know, I stand a good chance of being able to play good defense. You got T Mills on an instant burner. He can light it up from anywhere. Like I said, he ain't a kerosene heater. He ain't a gas stove. He's not the gas. Look, yo, what are you doing? Like I said, that's what most pure sharpshooters try to do right there. But, you know, I knew they were going to make him throw the ball away. 2K, why can't a man make a grown man can't make a wide open pass? But anyway, he ain't his kerosene stove. He's not the kindling wood. He's the instant burner, dog. That's what he is. But like I said, this is what you get a lot of times, what you see a lot of times. You got guys begging for screens and all that like that. But he's the playmaking sharp. I'm the defensive guy. Look at that. I just get a block. He can't get to the screen. And then we got the guy wide open in the corner. Cash trays up. Splash down. We have the dude that just throws the ball at the ceiling, man. He just throws them up there. Like I said, these points get on the board in a hurry. I have never witnessed it. Like I said, I'm not saying that it doesn't happen. I'm just saying that I've never witnessed this close up. We went on a 15-game streak so quick that it didn't even make a difference. Look at T. Trays up, splash down, get him out of here. Like, we went up, look how fast that game was. That was a quick game. We went on a 15-game, 16-game streak so quick with this guy, man. And it's just crazy because that's a bad game for him. Dude, he was hitting 5 for 5, 6 for 6. Like, I see what the hype is about now. Like, normally I never, I didn't play with a pure sharp because I, a sharp shooter, because I feel like what I lack in being able to just hit from everywhere on the court, I more than make up for in defense, right? With both of my bills. As you can see, I was playing defense right there. They normally would have gotten at least 2 more buckets, but I blocked a couple of shots, but I had 2 blocks on that one. And then I had a steal, and we had a steal. So we were playing defense, finishing in transition, just having the ball. But it's crazy because they let T play defense, and then they let Finesse at 6'10", pure sharpshooter. They allow him to play defense. He was getting blocks, he's getting steals. When they try to switch off in the center roll to the hole, he's able to pick him up. It was insane, dog. Like, I see what the hype is about now. Like I said, dog, everybody on our team can shoot the ball. And when everybody on your team can shoot the ball, it opens up a world of possibilities. I do miss having the guaranteed bucket, like where you got somebody inside that can get you a guaranteed bucket to go to the rim. But if the court is completely wide open, then T. Mizzle can be that guy. He can go straight to the rim and get the bucket. They know they can't play off of Finesse. And, you know, they definitely can't play off T. Mizzle. And you saw what happened if they play off me, so you can't play. This is kind of what I was talking about yesterday when I'm like, it's the perfect counterpunch, because the guy was a pure post scorer, but I made him so uncomfortable because he couldn't just go down low and spam and get buckets, just trying to get an easy bucket inside. But at the same time, he couldn't just sit in the paint and play defense. And if he did, well, you saw what happened to him. I mean, he gives up 4 for 4. And then when he does rush me out there and try to close out, I'm able to go to the rim. And the beautiful thing about my build is, it's something I didn't think about yesterday, I'm the center. I don't have to worry about getting my shot blocked, because if he rushes out there, the center is out here. I can just go straight to the rim, or I can do the reverse layup. The only person that's gonna block it is the center. That's the only reason I ever got my shot blocked as the small forward. Anyway, man, I just wanted to say that, man. I see what the hype is about. I don't know what 2K was thinking when they made these guys like this. They can make step backs. They can make really anything. I still gotta put that video up about the dude that I was playing where he had his Steph Curry kind of guy, and that was Kawhi. Dog, that dude was giving me the Dickens. But it is what it is, man. Like I said, I see what the hype is about now. I see why people made pure sharpshooters. But if you're not shooting like that, I think a sharpshooter is worthless if you're not working off the ball and putting points on the board in a hurry. Because if you have to play like Gravity Falcon did, where he was really just 1 for 1, he really just got 1 shot, you're useless. So they're not broken, but if you know how to play this game, any position is broken. Like, that's really how it is. But sharpshooter just appears to be more broken than the other positions because you get 3 rather than 2. Anyway, man, I already talked too long. I hope you guys understand what I'm trying to tell y'all, man. Pure sharpshooters, they are, they're fun to play with, man. I do enjoy having one on my team that can get a bucket. And you got a point guard that can work him open, so when he kicks it out to him, he is wide open, man. I did enjoy having that on my team. Anyway, 3 videos today, man. Y'all already see we're grinding. NBA is coming up here pretty soon. We're going to have daily NBA videos, so make sure you keep it locked. Make sure you give this video a like and subscribe if you're new. And I'm out of here. Till next time. It's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Holla! This joker said, I have not witnessed Aurora Borealis before, but that doesn't mean that when I see it the first time, that it won't be crazy. I don't know, man. I don't know where I come up with this stuff, man. I'm gone, man. He went from cursing the Falcons out to Aurora Borealis. I don't get it. I'm out. Peace.